It's been nearly 3 decades, and SOLIDWORKS 2024 still gives us great new sketch enhancements. If you work with sketch blocks, you're sure to appreciate these. In SOLIDWORKS 2024, we can now easily tell if our sketch blocks are fully defined. Much like an underdefined sketch, a dash will appear to the left of the block that's not fully defined. In this example, the sketch block for the wheel is underdefined. We can edit the block and add a dimension for the inner diameter. This fully defines the sketch, and now the block no longer has the minus sign beside it. Now in SOLIDWORKS 2024, we can hide individual sketch blocks with the same sketch. This allows us to direct our focus towards specific portions of our design. We have a mounting plate that needs some additional holes. SOLIDWORKS 2024 now gives us sketch dimension previews. It makes it even faster to fully define our sketches. Selecting sketch entities will show a preview of a smart dimension for that selection. Selecting this preview will automatically create the smart dimension, while clicking away from the preview will avoid this dimension creation and the preview will disappear. Selecting multiple entities will show the additional options, such as angular or diameter dimensions. Now that our sketch is fully defined, we'll look at another great enhancement. SOLIDWORKS 2024 makes it even easier to define the position of hole wizard holes. Let's create some countersunk mounting holes in this plate. After specifying the hole type, we move to the Position tab to define their location. In SOLIDWORKS 2024, we can now select existing 2D sketch. Holes are placed at the endpoints of the sketch segments. We can also include endpoints of construction geometry if desired. There's also an option to skip instances, making it easy to get the layout we need. Jumping back to our bowhead assembly, let's look at some more great feature enhancements. Here we have a cylindrical shaped component that needs some additional material removed. In SOLIDWORKS 2024, we have a new option for revolved cuts, flip side to cut. This makes it easy to control which side is kept and which portion is removed with the cut. Creating a bounding box is a great way to identify the stock size needed. SOLIDWORKS 2024 gives us the ability to create a cylindrical bounding box. We can have this defined by the best fit, or we can identify a planar face to align it. This crank arm is a great example for looking at an enhancement to linear patterns. We need to pattern the triangular cutout in both directions. SOLIDWORKS 2024 makes that easier than ever by giving us a new symmetric option. Using the same part, we'll look at another great 2024 enhancement, this one to the untrimmed surface feature. We already have an exterior surface created that contains the triangular cutouts. When doing an untrimmed feature, SOLIDWORKS 2024 now gives us an option for exclude parent surface. With this enabled, the surfaces created to patch the opening will not be knit to the parent geometry and are, instead, their own separate bodies. Another great part and feature enhancement has us looking at assemblies. This subassembly contains 3 metal tubes that will be welded together. SOLIDWORKS 2024 gives us a new option to turn an assembly into a multi-body part. This can provide greater flexibility with more tools available when you're working with a part file as opposed to an assembly file. After selecting the document template, we can identify any additional geometry that we would like to transfer to this new part file in addition to the solid bodies. Exploring the feature tree, you can see the 3 solid bodies in addition to the surface bodies. The part file references the parent assembly, and the modifications made in that assembly will propagate to this multi-body part file. In this example, the multi-body part file allows us to create a fillet weld bead as actual geometry. This would provide more accurate mass properties information that we wouldn't be able to get from the initial subassembly file.